Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you, and again I am here to teach you SST Standard 3, Chapter 1, Our Universe. So, I have explained you much about the universe, about the galaxy and about the sun, stars. Now today, we will teach you the page number 8, the solar systems. But before starting that topic, just take a short look at what we have learned in our first videos. And whatever the homework, please you guys write, complete it in your fair copy. And you can go through the website and then you can just check your homework and complete it in your fair copy. So let's take the short look at what we have learned and in video 1. Now, first of all, when we look up at this night sky, then what we will see? What do we see? We see stars. Stars is what? It is also a large ball of hot burning gases. Star is also a large balls of hot and burning gases. In fact, what do we see in the morning sky? We see the sun. Sun is also a star. Sun is also what? It's like a star. It gives also a heat and light. Sun looks bigger and brighter than the other stars, than all the stars, because it is nearer to the earth. Sun is nearest to the earth. Next, if you will look to the sky through the telescope, if we will see in the sky, then what we will see? We will see a very big space, very vast and very big space. So this is what? This is our universe. So that space is called what? Our universe. Now, the universe, what? Universe contains thousands of stars, planets and other heavenly bodies. Next, what is galaxy? Then, a large group or a cluster of stars. Clusters means a group of things of the same kind. So, a large group or cluster of stars is called what? Is called a galaxy. Now, there are many galaxies in the universe. Now, how was the universe formed? I have explained you in video 1. I am just telling you. How was universe formed? So, many years ago, there was a big explosion or a bang. And a huge fireball was created. The fireball spread out over a, it spread out over a what? It over a all space, over a big space. And then it slowly cooled down. And then what? Teeny particles were formed. Now after many thousands of years, these all particles, the smallest particles, it come together and to form the heavenly bodies. Then what? After that, the scientists believe that this is how our universe was created. This idea is known as the Big Bang Theory. Next is what? We live on the planet of Earth, which is a teeny part of galaxy called the Milky Way and the Akashganga. You can see the Milky Way galaxy is there. So this is what the Earth is, what our teeny particle of galaxy, which is called the Milky Way or Akashganga. Many years after the Big Bang, the sun and our planets of our solar system formed near the edge of the Milky Way. So after the many years, the Big Bang theory, the all scientists, they what the planet of our systems, they formed what Milky Way on the near our planet. Next is page number 8, the solar system. Now what is solar system? This picture shows you the solar system. Just look at your right side. So here we can see our solar system. You can see the sun, then Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So these all is what? It's our solar system. So here homework is what I am giving to you, that you have to complete down your homework. Learn it homework. I think solar system, I think you have learned, but once again you just learn with spelling. Now it includes the sun. It includes what? Sun. The 8 planets are there, and in fact moons or satellites are also there, or piece of rocks and dust is also there in our solar system. The sun lies at the center of the solar system. The sun is what? Sun is at the center of our solar system. After the sun, the most important members, after the sun, the most important members of the solar systems are its planet. So like Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus. In fact, the Earth is what? So the Earth is what? Earth is the third planet from the solar system. The word planet comes from a Greek word. The word planets, from where it comes? It comes from the Greek word, which means what? Which means wondered. Which means wonder. All the planets in the solar system move around. All the planets in the solar systems, they move around the sun at their different distance and different speeds. Next, all the planets have two kinds of movements, which one? Rotation and revolution. What is rotation? They spin round and round on an imaginary line. Only we can imagine, it's not the exactly line, called an axis. Imaginary line called an axis. So this movement is called what? Rotation. This movement is called rotation. Again, I am repeating that, what is rotation? They spin round and round on an imaginary line called an axis. And this movement is called what? Rotation. Now, what is revolution? The planets and satellites in the solar system, they move around the sun. So this movement is called as revolution. Again, I am repeating about the revolution. Planets and satellites also revolve or move around the sun. So all the planets also revolve and around the sun. So that movement is called what? Revolution. That movement are called revolution. Next is what? Many planets in the solar system have a small companions called satellites. So every planets in the solar system, they have a small companions that is called what? Satellites moving around them. Satellites moving around the all planets. These satellites vary in size, shape and number. This satellite is what? It's big in size, shape and number. The Earth has only one satellite. And the Earth is what? The Earth has only one satellite, the Moon. Satellite is what? The Moon, which shines in the sky at night. So the Earth satellite is what? The Moon, which shines what? In the sky at night. The Sun is only body in the solar system that has its own light. The Sun is what? It's only one satellite and only one body is in the solar system that has their own lights, because from the Sun, all the solar system gets the light. Planets and satellites have no light of their own. Planets and satellites, they don't have the lights. They shine because they reflect the light of the sun. That's why they shine. Here, did you know? For many years, our solar system had 9 planets. 9 planets, one of them is what? Pluto. Nowadays, we call Pluto a dwarf planet, and the number has given also 1,34,340. Now your chapter has completed. The homework, new words, if you have the book, then write down. And the all things I will upload on the website, so please go through the website and then check your homework. Thank you and have a nice day.